Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you my C project, which is how to write your own personal diary management system. So basically I choose this project because it requires some skills to manage the string, which is quite challenging to me. And personally I write a diary too, so hope you guys can enjoy it. So before that, notice that, keep in mind that the username here is abc123 and the password will be abc321. You can change it by your own later. So there are three very useful functions in this project I want to introduce, which is string comparison, fflush, and system clear screen. The string comparison allows you to compare the differences between two strings, and it is usually used in the password function. The fflush allows you to flush the buffered data, while the system clear screen allows you to clear off the unwanted things in your screen so that you are able to obtain a very clean main menu. So let's look into it. In this project, there are six functions, which is main, password, menu, write, read, and exit. Basically, we will go into the main, type the password, and then go into the menu, and then we will choose to write, read, or exit. So let's get into it. Welcome to the personal diary. You can see there's a book on the rack. This is an art. You can obtain it very easily from ASCII art. And click anyone, and you can see there's animals, building place, books. In my case, I choose books. You can make your own as well by using the converter, and you just copy them and place it in your program in printf row by row. So actually this is my book on the book rack. Now let's verify your identity. Press any key to continue. As I said just now, the password will be and username will be abc123 and abc321. But let's try if we write abc32 for the password. Verification error. Please try again. So this is the wrong password. Now we try the correct one, abc123 and abc321. Verification successful. So notice that just now the things have been flushed away, been cleaned away by the clear screen function, which is this system clear screen. I don't know. So welcome to the main menu. There are three things we can do for our option: 1. Write, 2. Read, and 3. Exit. Now I will slowly introduce you about these three functions. Let's write. This is a scroll, and this is a feather and a pen. It is also an art for decoration purpose. So it will also show you the local date and time, which is according to my own time in my device. So how do we do that? In the write function, we include the time header file, time.h, and after that we try to write something like this, and then you will get the local time. Okay, the next. Now we are going to enter the today's date for the diary. As a diary writer, you will notice that usually we use the date as the file name, right? So this is also the file name, so it will be entered automatically. For today's content, let's say today is a good day. Then write in content, today is a good day, for you to check. Writing safe, returning to the main menu. Notice that at here, there's a new file, and you can look at it in notepad, the same as the thing you write just now, at this time. Today is a good day. Okay, since the type, the mode I use is A, A stands for appending. So now let's say I write again on the same file, 11-04-2020. Today's content, alright? Today is also a sunny day. Written content, today is also a sunny day for you to check. Write save, writing saved, returning to the main menu. Now, open again this file in the notepad. You notice that there's a new line written here because the mode I use is appending mode. So we will write continuously until infinity. And notice that it shows you that when is the time you write this thing. So basically they are written at different time. Let's write a new one. Let's say tomorrow's date 12-04-2020. And today's content, today is going to be a rainy day. Okay, you notice that there's a new file appears here. Today is going to be a rainy day at this time. Notice that it is in April 11, not April 12. We cannot change the time by ourselves. Okay, but we can modify the date. I don't know who wants to use that. Now we are going to see how to read the diary in this project. Two read function is activated, so you can see there's a book and a bad guy, and we can read the file with the name, the same name. Let's say 11-04-2020. You see there is a four line here. Today is a good day. Today is also a sunny day, which is same as this file. So press any key to continue. Do you want to continue reading? If you want to continue reading, just press 1 for the choice and 2 for no. Say yes. Read function is activated again. So now let's say we type another date, 04-2020, and it will show you as just now one line. Today is going to be a rainy day. Next, we choose no. You can also press another numbers because I have set it in the read function as default. Default means in if the case is not 1 or 2. So let's say we type 4. If it shows you error selection, let's go to the main menu. If you type case 2, it will show you OK, returning to the main menu. And then we'll be direct to the main menu again. Finally, I will show you the exit function. Just type 3, select an option 3, exit function is activated, and this is a door with a cat here. The system will be closing now. Press any key to continue. Here comes the end of the project. Hope you guys can enjoy it to the fullest content. Thank you for watching this video.